Over the last three decades, wage growth has slowed in many advanced economies, and the labor share of national income has fallen. Economists have proposed a number of explanations for these trends, but this paper explores another potential factor: changes in managerial attitudes and practices originating from business education. Using data from the US and Denmark, the authors show that CEOs with business school degrees, or business managers for short, reduce their employees' wages and effect a decline in the labor share of the firm. In both countries, the share of business managers has grown substantially over time, and the following results suggest they are a significant contributing factor to aggregate labor market patterns. To start, the authors estimate the causal effect of appointing a business manager. Using firm and worker-level data covering the last few decades, they compare firms that transitioned from a non-business to a business manager over this period with a control group of similar firms that had non-business managers throughout. These figures show the results for US firms. In the years leading up to a transition, treated firms evolve similarly to control firms. But the appointment of a business manager leads to a decline in wages and in the labor share of the firm. In the 5 years following the appointment, there is a 6% decline in wages and a 5 percentage point decline in the labor share. At the same time, there is no effect on sales, employment, or investment. Strikingly, and despite the different institutional context, the results for Danish firms are very similar. Here, the appointment of a business manager leads to a 3% decline in wages and a 3 percentage point decline in the labor share. Again, there is no impact on productivity or other economic outcomes. Importantly, these effects are specific to business managers. Transitioning from one non-business manager to another has no impact on wages or labor shares, and the same is true for transitions to a manager with a college or master's degree. This shows that the effects are not driven by the mere arrival of a new manager or by the appointment of a more educated one. But there is a potential concern. The decision to appoint a business manager is not random, and firms may hire one because they plan to cut labor costs. To address this, the paper shows that the results are very similar when the transition to a business manager is triggered by their predecessor's retirement or death, and when the appointment is driven by the diffusion of this practice among peer groups of firms. Overall, the results suggest that the wage policies of business managers have had a sizable impact on aggregate labor market patterns. In the US, where the fraction of workers employed by business managers increased from 26 to 43% between 1980 and 2020, business managers can explain 20% of the decline in the labor share and 15% of the slowdown in wage growth since 1980. In Denmark, they account for 6% of the decline in the labor share. These effects appear to be driven by business managers' unwillingness to share rents with workers. In the Danish data, it is possible to track firm-level responses to export demand shocks, and while positive shocks lead to higher hourly wages and annual income when a non-business manager is in charge, there is zero impact on wages when a business manager is in charge. This suggests that when business managers take control, they move firms away from sharing increases in profits and sales with workers. What explains these patterns? On one hand, they may reflect a causal effect of business education. The curriculum or content of these programs may produce managers who do not share rents with workers. On the other, selection may be an issue. individuals who are more likely to take a hard line against labor may also be more likely to go to business school. To distinguish between these, the authors exploit role model effects. High school students are more likely to pursue business degrees when a higher fraction of older students from their same school and with similar academic performance have chosen to do so. Results using this source of variation in business school attendance indicate that most of the estimated effects of business managers can be attributed to the causal effect of business education and not to selection. So, what is it about a business education that instills these attitudes? While this paper lacks the data to provide a definitive answer, the authors note that two doctrines commonly espoused in business schools are the importance of shareholder value and of creating lean corporations stripped of unnecessary costs. This combination may produce managers who see maximizing shareholder value as their primary responsibility and who view workers as sources of costs to be reduced. And in fact, shareholders do benefit from the practices of business managers. Their appointments lead to higher profits and stock market values. Nonetheless, further work is needed to determine the precise channels through which business education shapes managerial practices, and to establish whether the patterns found here apply in other contexts. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on the decline of the labor share, rent sharing in corporations, and business ethics.